extensive itineraries that will take you to these exciting ports of call. You can enjoy the luxury on board or explore each fascinating culture on land. The choice is all yours. Treat yourself to a cruise with us. Talk to the experts at the Club Voyage travel office nearest you and sail right into summer.
The move is on. Explosive cars turning heads. Dynamic people on the move to Avenue. Turn on the heat at Avenue Pontiac, Buick, Cadillac. People going places, and there's only one place to eat the heat. Yes, your cars, your place. Avenue Pontiac, Buick, Cadillac. The Carry at Van Horn.
Pulse for Monday. Have a good night.
LA Law, Thursdays at 10 for the best in drama.
The recognized symbol of excellence in sports entertainment.
Wrestling is on the air. Hello, everyone. This is Vince McMahon at ringside, along with, of course, wrestling's only living legend, Bruno Sammartino. And, of course, yes, indeed, joining us as well, Jesse the Body Ventura. We have all kind of action set for you right about now. To join us will be the British Bulldogs, former World Wrestling Federation tag team holders. Also to join us, another great tag team combination, and boy are they in the news as of late, making reference, of course, to the Islanders. And then from there, yes, he's back, and his bite louder, and I'll tell you something, that bite is something else indeed. The Junkyard Dog will join us, as well as, ladies and gentlemen, as we promised, the Intercontinental title matchup. The champion, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, will square off against the number one challenger from Memphis, Tennessee, the Honky Tonk Man. Let's go right up now.
Wait, just a minute. You're forgetting the most important thing, McMahon. Out of the goodness of my heart, we're going to see film footage exclusively from Jesse the Body Ventura and the Predator. I'll show you I'm a movie star.
All right, with that in mind, now let's go up to the ring announcer, Howard Finkel.
This is a tag team contest scheduled for one fall. In the ring to my right, at a total combined weight of 486 pounds, from Romania, Johnny Canine. His partner from San Antonio, Texas, Dusty Wolf. And their opponents, to be escorted towards the ring by Matilda.
The British Bulldogs on their way to the ring. Dynamite Kid and Davey Boy Smith, and they personify action in the World Wrestling Federation. What a turn! Look at that! Whoa!
Now, I'm getting sick and tired of seeing them using that dog, that attack dog, to attack wrestlers in the ring.
That's not an attack dog. Give me a break.
What is it that you call it does?
That's one of the most lovable animals I think ever. Take a look at Matilda. She is so sweet. How about you ever met her?
The way that dog attacks us like it ain't been fed in 2 months.
Well, if anyone is tenacious, it's certainly the British Bulldog. As now, Davey Boy starts things off against John Canine. Davey Boy, Dynamite, would like nothing better than to once again reign as tag team champions of the World Wrestling Federation. Nice move by Davey Boy. Right back. John Canine takes him over this time. Loses momentum right outside the ring. Nice maneuver.
Yeah, it was definitely Davey Boy caught Canine going underneath and upset him, and it caused Canine to lose his timing out onto the floor, and the man may be injured.
One of the things about the British Bulldogs, Bruno, they're so unpredictable, they're so quick, lightning-like speed these Bulldogs possess, as well as those kind of moves.
They possess quite a bit of strength, too. This Smith, well, dynamite, too, but they have a lot of power. Sometimes look at their speed and forget about their strength.
But, you know, I have to make mention, I just don't think they've been totally on their game since losing the titles.
Yeah, I don't think so.
I think it psyched them out, and they haven't recovered from it since the Hearts took the titles from them.
Canine to the bunker.
Tag is made now. The secret, perhaps, of the Bulldogs' success just might be the one and the only Matilda. Earlier on, we had an occasion to get a real good look. Now, Jesse, take a look at this. There.
I'm looking.
Isn't that a beautiful animal? Look at those teeth. Look at that black liver around her.
Why don't you take her home for about a week, McMahon, and find out if she's house-trained?
I don't know about being house-trained, but she's quite a pet, Matilda. Some mascot for the British Bulldogs. Tag mate now, dynamite kid in the ring. Ooh, double headbutt.
You know, now that you mention it, the Bulldogs do look a lot like Matilda. The three of them do, yeah.
And Dusty Wolf to the buckle. Dynamite Kid measured him, and ooh, what a headbutt.
Dynamite Kid is devastating with those headbutts. I'll tell you, though, many times when he delivers them, he hurts himself, though, in the process also.
Look at that maneuver, what a headbutt that is.
Go.
One, two, and lunch out of dragon.
The British Bulldog, Rick Hardy, here on the opener, the British Bulldog.
Dynamite Kid, Davey Boy Smith, and the British Bulldog. As we go back now, Bruno, and take a look at this maneuver, I believe by Davey Boy. No, it's Dynamite there.
I'll tell you, the Bulldogs are looking as great as ever. We just saw a great clothesliner by Dynamite Kid, but now look at Davey Boy Smith as he goes from the top rope, and here he comes, torpedo down on his head, right down on pin island. My goodness, and here's your pin.
Matilda can be very proud of the British Bulldogs. Now let's take you to Frank the George.
Hi again, everyone. Over the last few weeks, we've been detailing superstar Billy Graham's comeback attempt after that serious hip operation. Now, the superstar is shocking everybody with his quick recovery. And let me tell you something, in no small way, his return home has helped immensely. Just being in that Arizona air, working in the 100-degree heat in the mountains, well, that return home may be his best therapy to date. Well, superstar, after the extent of the surgery, the things that you have gone through, a brand new metal hip. What are we doing here in desolate Arizona?
Craig, superstar Billy Graham, I've got to get back. I got to hear the roar of the crowd. I got to feel the pandemonium. It's in my blood. I had to come back here to my roots, to where you got to survive. Superstar Billy Graham, out here with the snakes, the scorpions, the heat, and the desolation.
The superstar has been recovering quite well, but it has been an excruciatingly painful experience for him. Billy Graham is a driven man, and even in the face of this tragically career-ending injury, he has pushed his therapy to limits that an ordinary individual could never endure.
Okay, it must be fatiguing a little bit. Hold it on the way down. There you go. Good.
One more?
Good.
One more. Just do one more. I want to do one more.
Okay. Good. Okay. Try not to hold your breath.
Of course, Billy Graham is no ordinary individual, nor is he even an ordinary athlete. He is one of a very rare breed in the most elite class of athletes, a former world heavyweight champion. That title, of course, only comes to those who are blessed by nature with uncanny strength and determination. However, his apparent abundance of determination has his physicians concerned because too much activity, quite frankly, could be very dangerous. And they say a return to the ring is impossible. But for an athlete like Billy Graham, who has been pushing his limits to achieve his goals all of his life, it's hard to bet against the guy, even though it may look like he's trying to beat a royal flush. But comeback or not, we all must applaud his purpose, his struggle, and perseverance to get back to the squared circle. And yes, superstar Billy Graham insists that he will be back. We'll be right back.
distinguishes the American Express card from the others. Member. And membership has its privileges.
Our card, our cash.
Even our passport. You've come to the right place. I can help you.
That's great. That was an easy sale.
No need to wrap it.
Bangkok today. Yeah, I'm packed.
To apply for membership, look for this display and take one.
Whoever you are, whatever shape you're in, we have the waterbed to fit your body exactly. At National Waterbed, now featuring this beautiful solid pine four-piece suite natural finish for only $666. And as a bonus, you get a beautiful comforter free with the purchase of any waterbed. You'll find the waterbed of your dreams, whoever you are, whatever shape you're in.
National Waterbed! National Waterbed!
Give me a light. Bud Light.
If you just ask for a light beer, you never know what you'll get.
Give me light. Bud Light.
So if you want the light beer with a great name and taste, ask for Bud Light, because everything else is just a light.
Buy your friend a beer.
Bud Light, the beer with the first name and taste, is brewed in Quebec by Labatt.
To cool off, let's take you now to Outback Jack.
G'day, you blokes. Boy, oh boy, I tell you what, those Islanders are hot. And when it gets hot around the WWF, you get a WWF Superstars ice cream bar. They cool things off. No worry.
Well, things certainly are not going to cool off in this match.
You found that humor. This tag team battle is scheduled for
what was so humorous about that? I'll tell you after Finkel's announcement here.
Total combined weight of 483 pounds from Columbia, South Carolina, Eric Cooper. His partner from Antigua in the West Indies, SD Special Delivery Jones.
SD always a long time.
And their opponents to be led towards the ring by their manager, Bobby from Green.
About the juicy Outback Jack, Outhouse Jack bite that ice cream. I mean, he can't take a full bite. There's a space in there. Half the bar's left.
Well, he's missing a few teeth, yes.
He could floss with a rope. The Islanders, Haku and Tama, who recall just several weeks ago when it was the Islanders needs a real rain, huh? The Islanders in the ring against Martel Zink in what was a scientific matchup until the Islanders apparently fell under the spell, if you will, the siege of Bobby the Brain Heenan. Do you think they're better off, the Islanders, with Heenan?
Definitely, definitely. Heenan's going to negotiate contracts for these guys. He's going to get them the kind of matches they deserve. They can't help but be improved with Bobby Heenan.
Nice maneuver there. Very nice. That's Tama. Tama scooped up and slammed to the canvas.
We had an occasion to chat with Martel and Zink, the Can-Am Connection. Earlier on, you can bet they're not going to take this latest turn of events sitting down. Here's what they had to say.
If the Islanders think that they're going to attack us from behind and join the Bobby Heenan family and get away with it, no way. Let me tell you something. You got an obstacle on your way to the tag team belt, and that is the Can-Am Connection. You're in the Heenan family, but we're in a family of our own. Rick Martel and Tom Zink, the Can-Am Connection. Hang on to Heenan, because you're going to need him, brother. Yes. The Can-Ams ain't stopping.
Yes, sir.
Tell you what, those Can-Ams are something else. That's right, but the Can-Ams definitely fell in the rankings when they lost to the Islanders.
A bit, no question of that. I don't know how long they'll stay down there. I would suspect not very long.
And right there, you see the Islanders' improvement with Heenan. You think they could have beat the Can-Am without Heenan?
I don't know. Bruno, your thoughts?
I don't know if they could have beat the Can-Am. It certainly was a great bout, but what I'll say about them now is that as great as they were under Heenan with the new tactics they used, they are more dangerous and tougher now than they've ever been.
Wow, for once, I'm going to agree with Bruno. Can you believe that?
Maneuver by Tama. The cover. Hey, come on. Hey, come on. Hey, come on.
pick him up, you can cheer Heenan.
Yes, indeed. These are definitely Bobby the Brain Heenan tactics. Although somewhere down deep in the Islanders, there had to be this reserve, so to speak. This sort of feeling for the likes of a Bobby the Brain Heenan, if not the Heenan himself.
Well, you know what that feeling is?
What?
That feeling is called winning. That's what the feeling is.
Oh, my, SD caught from behind. SD hammering it out on the far side, meanwhile. Uh-oh, woo. Come on, ref. Maintain some order here. I'll figure out who's the legal man in the ring.
Wow.
Hey, come on, what's he gonna do? He's fighting these Islanders, just have at it.
He's counting, he's talking to Heenan. Heenan probably saw something he didn't like. There it is. A nice fair three count.
The winners of this contest, the Islanders.
Haku and Tama, the Islanders. Victorious. Let's take you back now to the replay. Bruno, let's take a look at it.
There's no question the Islanders are tougher than they've ever been. Look at this double headshot from Cooper. If that wasn't enough. Well, here we go now for the pin. We missed the previous move, but it was just devastating. And easy victory for the Islanders.
I'm sure we'll be seeing a great deal more of Bobby the Brain Heenan and the Islanders. Let's take you now to a special interview.
Out of Montreal Forum, Monday night, the 29th of June, the World Wrestling Federation will be back in La Belle Province. Come on in, Pat Patterson. Greg the Hammer Valentine, Dino Bravo. Pat Patterson, you have stirred up a hornet's nest. Who in the world do you think you are? Now all of a sudden...
Who do you think I am? I am the dream of Quebec. And second of all, I don't need to talk to you. I want to talk to the Rougeau brothers.
Well, go right ahead.
Les frères Rougeau, mais vous contez une petite histoire. Vous avez encore 12 ans, vous allez à l'école encore, vous allez vous chercher un barbouillé. Quand t'es jeune, appelle pas ça un barbier, appelle ça un barbouillé. Ouais,
hein? Ben oui, barbouillé.
Là, parce que les Rougeaux, ils veulent que Pat Patterson, que ça, Bravo et Valentine se font couper les cheveux. Comprends-tu ça?
Absolutely.
Hein, you understand?
Oui.
Very well. Rougeau, je vais vous dire une chose. Vous avez fait belle la dernière fois au forum, j'avais mangé une volée, vous allez en manger une autre. À ce coup-ci, c'est vous autres qui va se faire couper les cheveux. Ça sera pas Bravo, ça sera pas l'oreille du Québec, ça sera pas Valentine, ça va être les Rougeaux. Ils vont avoir l'air de Little Beaver et Mr. T.
All right, Nils, this guy looked good. He's a little marginal right now.
Ouais, faut que j'admette que ce qu'il dit, c'est la vérité. Ils viennent avec l'intention de nous couper les cheveux. C'est eux autres qu'on fait couper les cheveux. C'est la seule affaire qui me reste à faire au Forum de Montréal. Après, oui, les avoir battus la dernière fois au Forum. Là, on va les battre pour encore. Là, c'est nous autres qui vont les couper les cheveux au petit Rougeau.
It's all French to me, but I know when I get into that ring that a universal language is a good slap in the face, and the figure four leg lock is also a universal language. And Beefcake, I want you. And I know my two partners are going to be behind me 100%.
I can't believe you, Patterson. What?
You understand
who do you think you are? I can't believe. Montreal, the 29th at the Forum.
Enjoy extra sugar-free gum.
You get extra flavor, extra fun in extra sugar-free gum.
Extra sugar-free gum with NutraSweet won't promote tooth decay and gives you extra refreshing flavor that lasts an extra, extra, extra long time.
Extra flavor for that extra long ride. Extra flavor for that extra long ride. When you chew it, extra, the extra fresh flavor lasts an extra, extra, extra long time.
Sugar-free extra lasts extra long.
The move is on. Explosive cars turning heads. Dynamic people on the move to Avenue. Turn on the heat at Avenue Pontiac, Buick, Cadillac. People going places, and there's only one place to meet the heat. Yes, your cars, your place. Avenue Pontiac, Buick, Cadillac. To carry at Van Horn.
When I come to Toronto, I come to play.
When I come to Toronto, I come to play.
Toronto, discover.
From Disney and Joe Camp, it's Benji, stranded in a hostile wilderness and trying to get back to civilization. But he's found four cougar cub orphans who need his help. And now, Benji must find them a new home and a new family. It's a story of incredible courage and tenderness. A story you'll want to share with your family. Walt Disney Pictures and Joe Camp present Benji the Hunted.
Starts Friday at a Famous Players Theater near you. Check your local listings.
In a moment, we're going to find out what kind of movie star Jesse the Body Ventura really is, courtesy of 20th Century Fox. Let's take you now.
Wait a minute. I'm the star of this movie, The Predator, and it's courtesy of me, not 20th Century Fox. This is the greatest piece of film you're ever going to see, McMahon. Right here, let's go to The Predator starring Jesse the Body.
Payback time.
Get that load.
Say, or whether it's in real life in the ring or in the film, you always have that equalizer. You're always cheating. You always got something on your side nobody
cheating.
Else has.
Cheating? That's called the power, brother. What do you mean, cheating?
Let's go up to ringside.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. In the ring from Tampa, Florida, weighing 241 pounds.
Wasn't that Arnold Schwarzenegger I saw in there? Yeah. He's the star of Predator, not you.
And his opponent from
returning to the World Wrestling Fest. What an ovation!
Well, I'll say this about him. The guy's looking bigger than I've ever seen him before. He's definitely been in the gym. He looks well-trained.
Wait a minute now. Back from behind here. Junkyard Dog with a crisscross going round and round. Down to the canvas. The dog right back up and... Oh, what a hip match maneuver by the dog. Headbutt that missed. Clothesline down to the canvas. Gibbs in control.
Well, I'll tell you, Gibbs is a wily veteran. He's going to give the JYD everything he wants.
Got him to us all he can get on Big Junkyard Dog. I think you're right, Jesse. I think the dog looks like he's much heavier.
He's solid. The man looked, whoa, look at that. There was a mistake by Gibbs. You never hit this guy in the head. Never.
Junkyard Dog with a headbutt. Down goes Gibbs. Up on his feet, maybe not for long, as the Junkyard Dog with Terry Gibbs whips him to the rope, right back out. There's a clothesline. The Junkyard Dog had a few comments earlier on before the broadcast this week. Here's what the dog had to say.
1987, now you can see the new dog coming from behind closed doors, fighting meaner than ever. I'm gonna tell you one thing, the dog is fighting and biting.
He's that. Fighting and biting. The Junkyard Dog looks great.
I'll tell you, not only did his body get bigger and thicker, I believe his skull may have gotten thicker. He's really going to the head box.
Junkyard Dog with Terry gives it a compromising position.
Is that possible, Bruno, to thicken your skull?
I don't know about thickening the skull, but I'll tell you one thing. He is bigger, you're right, but he's also quicker, more energetic. Look at the power slam.
Power slam. Yes, sir. I got it. The Junkyard Dog. He's something else indeed. It all started right here in the neighborhood.
Here is your winner, the Junkyard Dog.
The Junkyard Dog victorious. I'm sure we're seeing a great deal more of the dog in weeks to come, and he's got somebody from his neighborhood. Yes, his worldwide neighborhood. They're all coming in there. Look at that. That dog's got him coming from all parts of his neighborhood.
Ah, come on, Bruno, sit down.
Let's go back to the replay.
Hey, I thought you watched. You can say what you like. The dog is bigger, quicker, better than ever. I believe this is where we're going to see that fantastic power slam. And look at this. Look at the devastation. He delivers it. Boom. And there's, look at there he gets. Went completely knocked out of him, and he's out for the count. Dog looks great.
And the dog is back. Fight in the fight. Let's take you now to some up to the date news.
All right, stay tuned. We're going to get you back up into the ring and just... Excuse me, gentlemen, am I interrupting anything over here? Heart Foundation, please come on in. Montreal's Forum, Monday night, June the 29th, the World Wrestling Federation. Back at the fabulous Forum, I'm looking forward to seeing my very dear, close, personal, longtime friend, Jean Beliveau, from the Montreal Canadiens. Oh, what are you laughing about?
Gene, isn't it a real shame? Isn't it a real shame that the poor Montreal Canadiens, that they never went to the Cup this year? Tough break, guys.
They just
went to Alberta. Alberta won it. Edmonton.
Edmonton, right? You're from Calgary.
It's
you guys
it's
went down the
enough.
Sewer. What
it's
are you talking
enough.
About? Let's talk about the Killer Bees.
Yeah, let's talk about the Killer Bees. I guess you can kind of compare the Killer Bees to the Canadians. They're both losers. They're has-beens. They wouldn't know a hockey puck from a beehive.
You've got to be kidding me. Killer Bees, very capable. Otherwise, gentlemen, in all due respect, they would not be the number one contenders right now.
Listen, Gene, I think there's a mistake here. Jimmy, are you sure the Killer Bees? Did we sign for a match with Killer
Bees? Let me tell you something, baby. We just hope they try to put the little mask on, because if you do, we got a big surprise for you. Try to pull a switch on the Heart Foundation, Daddy. Right, Anvil?
Yeah. Oh, isn't that so cute? The way they... Who's Brian Blair? Who's Jim Brunzel? We don't know which is which!
Good, baby.
That's right, they fake you out with those masks, right?
Yeah, real well, we're on to them. You know what we're going to do? We're going to spray paint the top of their heads. That's what
Well, gentlemen, I wish you the very best in your title defense on Monday night, June the 29th, Montreal Forum. By the way, there's another grade up
by
there.
By the way!
Wait a minute. Are you
Jimmy Hart has been telling us we have this foreign language teacher at the Hart Foundation, and she
what?
She gave us a little model from Montreal.
Stacy Bone.
You guys are sick. Stay tuned. We're going to be right back. Really.
Kung Fu, an ancient art in a modern world, benefits all participants. Proper skills and training gives true confidence. Ensuring peace of mind. Kung Fu Canada. By appointment only. Phone 363-1015.
Watch. Only one of these cameras is flashing on Duracell batteries. And only one will catch the hatching. Top battery. The one that lasts.
Here she comes. She's the lady in red. CFCF 12's mystery woman. She may choose you. Be on the lookout.
Hey, mystery woman.
Celebration is back, and it's your chance to win. The grand prize is one of these fabulous cars. From Avenue Pontiac Buick Cadillac, the Turbo Firefly. This new shadow from Desource Dodge Chrysler. Or from Lallier, the Honda Civic Hatchback. The choice is yours. Plus, celebration weekly prizes. This patio set from Centre Citadel. A king-size bed from National Waterbed. Audiotronic Sony Trinitron. And classic crystal from Kaplan Duval.
Hey, Mystery Woman.
She'll be back to tell you how you can win, beginning June 27th on CFCF 12.
The following is a tag team contest scheduled for one fall. About to enter the ring, introducing first the manager, Johnny V. And here is Johnny V's dream team at a total combined weight of 506 pounds from Montreal, Quebec, Canada, Dino Bravo.
his partner from Seattle, Washington, Greg the Hammer Valentine. Their opponents, at a total combined weight of 496 pounds, from Dallas, Texas, Scott Casey. His partner from Downers Grove, Illinois, Leaping Lenny Hoffman. And now, a poem from Mr. Papa.
All right. Listen up, Jess.
I'm listening.
The Superstars of Wrestling is a Nielsen delight, and the ratings just get better every show. While Vincent Bruno tried to give the fans a lot of class, Jesse tries to make it Larry Curly Moe. I saw him in The Predator with Arnold Schwarzenegger. Jesse's presence made the movie really great. I hope the movie earns him an Academy Award. He's the man the wrestling fans just love to hate.
Oh, my goodness, Leaping Lanny Poffo.
Well, I'll tell you something. You know, I know I'm a movie star now. You know how I know it?
How's that?
Even Bruno came up and asked me for an autograph, and I didn't give it to him.
That's what my answer to that.
That is funny. Boy, at least you haven't lost your sense of humor, I'm going to say that. Here we go back up now.
I'll tell you, I'm impressed with this new Dream Team, though. I think they're stronger than they ever were with Beefcake. I think Bravo has more strength, and he's a slicker wrestler.
Think so, huh?
Yep, and that's going to make the Hammer that much more devastating.
Nice maneuver to part of Scott Casey. Nice arm drag takedown. And Dino, a little frustrated. Take a look at that head of hair there. Yes, that, of course, is courtesy of Brutus Beefcake. Courtesy of a, well, what kind of hairstyle would you call that?
Yes, sir. What do you call that guy?
Yeah, the skin.
Is that a mohawk or is it not enough? I don't know. But I'll tell you what, the way he tries to cover it, I don't think he's too proud of it.
Beefcake's been working on the hairstyle of Johnny B. And you wonder if he's going to have the opportunity. What would happen with that head of hair on Dino Bravo?
Well, I'll say this. I got to see Beefcake take a man like Bravo down and give him a haircut like that. Johnny B's a manager. You know, anybody can go around and bully a manager.
Think so, huh? Look at that shock of hair on Greg the Hammer Valentine. That proxided blonde hair. I wonder if one day we'll see that hair cut and all over the mat flying through the air.
You know, I wouldn't talk so hot. Valentine's liable to give you a haircut, McMahon.
Nice maneuver by the Hammer. Drops the elbow and misses. Scott Casey on his toes. Nice maneuver by Scott Casey.
Well, Casey's a veteran wrestler. He's been in the wars.
Indeed he has. Valentine, a scoop and a slam. Tag made now to Dino Bravo. Bravo, ooh, missing! Telegraphing that maneuver. Tag has made to come Leaping Lanny Poffo. Going downstairs. Ooh, he connected there. Drop kick! Poffo hammering away. Scoops his man up and a slam. Watch this maneuver. Yeah.
This could be an upset.
Boom.
That was very close to a major upset.
Bravo with tremendous power able to kick out. Now reversing things on. You saw that.
Oh, yes, I did. What a beautiful maneuver by Valentine.
Tag is made. Coming in now, Valentine.
That was smart tag team wrestling. Poffo got thrown in close enough to where Hammer could do the damage from the outside.
Valentine holds Poffo up there. What a suplex. Tag is made in now for Dino Bravo.
That was a cheap way to stop Poffo because Poffo really had him going at that time.
Whoa.
A cover, he may get him. Yes, indeed, a three count. See that smirk on the face of Bravo? The embrace now of Valentine.
The winners of this contest, the Dream Team.
The Dream Team, huh? Let's go back, take a look at what we saw earlier.
Now, here we go. Look at this. Here's the reversal. Now, here, look what Valentine does from the outside. He catches him with the foot right in his back, and here's Bravo as he scoops him up in the air, and now drives him down. Ooh, what a shot. But now, here it is. Look at the power of Bravo here. He scoops him up and now slams him right on that knee. Not on the knee. Drove down the line, slam like, and I'll tell you, that took all the wind out of Poffo.
Here, that hand in the face, too. Insult to injury. Let's take you now to the snake pit.
And now, Jake the Snake Roberts.
You know, sometimes you pick up the paper, you see something, you don't like it. Sometimes you're right there live in person, you don't like what you see. Sometimes you just hear about it. Well, one time at WrestleMania 3, there was something that made me pretty sick. And to show you what happened, I'm going to invite the two people that were involved, because there was a little man and there was a big man involved, too. Let's talk about contrast of people. Hillbilly Jim, your tag team partner, Little Beaver. I'll tell you the truth, Hillbilly. I'll keep the snake away from you, all right? I'll tell you the truth. I don't see you're a lucky man to be alive. He's a very lucky man.
Well, Jake, he is lucky. And I'll say this, that was the lowest thing I've ever seen. I'll tell you, at WrestleMania 3, King Kong Bundy did the lowest doggone thing anybody could ever do. He tried to hurt this little fella, and he wanted not only permanently injure him, but I think he wanted to put him out of professional wrestling out of life.
Now, what kind of man does that make you when you stand 6'2", weigh 450 pounds, and you jump on somebody like that, huh?
Makes you a coward, Jake. That's exactly what you are, King Kong Bundy, a big coward. And I can't wait, Jake, to get my chance. I can't wait to get my chance just to get a hold of you, King Kong Bundy, and show you that you ain't the man you thought you are. And I'll tell you this, you're a big coward, because anybody that would try to hurt a little fella like this ain't got no guts at all.
Little Beaver, do you have something you'd like to tell the people, my man?
Yes. I can say that I was hurt. I was in hospital. And I'm here to give this man here, Hillbilly Jim, advices, and that big fat, whatever you want to call him, he'll get it.
Well, the way I see it, it's all up to you, my man, because I tell you something, it doesn't matter what size you are, when you weigh 450 pounds and you splash somebody, you gotta hurt him.
Takes a big horse to pull a big load. I'm one big horse, King Kong Bundy.
That's right.
Hi, I'm Ricky Steamboat, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, telling you a little bit of a story right here and now. There's no better high than doing it naturally, on your own. Say no to drugs. It can't help you. It sure can't help you in the long run. Read about it in the newspapers. There's been a lot of great people going down, and been going down real hard. I'm a natural, I'm high, and I love it. Say no to drugs. It's the end thing to do.
Coppertone is now more moisturizing than ever, because now there's vitamin E and aloe in every drop. It's natural moisturizing for a healthy-looking summer glow.
Exciting things are happening at Sears Dad's number one sale. We have great gift ideas for every dad, from dress shirts to Arnold Palmer coordinates and more. Sears has contests. Dad could win a fantastic Jeep YJ or a golf game on Arnold Palmer's course and lunch with Arnie himself. Hurry and enter soon. Details are at all Sears retail stores. We're making Father's Day special at Sears, where you get your money's worth and more.
So, going away for your honeymoon, huh? Have you thought of Ontario? What? You mean you didn't know?
Little Chase, Ontario, really changed. Oh yes, Ontario, you really changed. You look so good morning to night. One of a kind, that's right.
So now you know where to go.
Oh, it's incredible, Ontario.
Coors Concerts present Paul Simon, The Graceland Tour with UMass Akela, Ladysmith Black Mambazo, and special guest Miriam Makeba. Thursday, June 25th, Montreal Forum. Great seats on sale at Ticketron and the Forum box office. The Montreal International Jazz Festival presents the Billie Holiday musical Lady Day at the Emerson Bar and Grill, starring Rainey Lee, on sale at Ticketron. Opens June 26th for 13 great shows at Club Soda. Produced by Donald K. Donald.
gentlemen, the following contest is for the Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship. It is scheduled at one fall. Introducing first the challenger, led towards the ring by his manager, Colonel Jimmy Hart, from Memphis, Tennessee, weighing 243 pounds, the Hunky Tonk Man.
Take a look at that. He's looking good, ain't he? Depends on your taste, Jesse. I hope he plays the guitar behind his back. I like it when he does that. Ah, he's not doing it.
And an undeserved title opportunity in my book.
Why?
I don't think he's deserving.
His opponent is from Hawaii. The Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Ricky the Dragon.
Back to what you said earlier, I want a clarification. Why do you feel Honky Tonk does not deserve a title shot?
Well, listen, there are many number one contenders.
Whoever you are, whatever shape you're in, we have the waterbed to fit your body exactly at National Waterbed. Now featuring this beautiful solid pine four-piece suite natural finish for only $666. And as a bonus, you get a beautiful comforter free with the purchase of any waterbed. You'll find the waterbed of your dreams, whoever you are, whatever shape you're in.
National Waterbed. National
Memories. I guess I was a typical teenager. I thought my parents were okay, but pretty square. I didn't really appreciate them till after I got married and came here and had children of my own. Now I'm sort of making up for lost time.
Saturday calls to many European countries are only $1.50 a minute. Pay a little, visit home.
Everyone is talking about Lachine Rapids Jet Boat Tour.
Spectacular.
It was great.
Extraordinaire.
Montreal's most exciting entertainment for everyone from 8 to 80. Get a group together now and come to Old Montreal and take advantage of Lachine Rapids Tour's special dinner package. An evening boat ride you'll never forget. And a visit to Le Cachot Sport in Old Montreal for a feast of chicken and ribs. Great food and spectacular fun. For more information and to book your group's dinner ride, call Lachine Rapids Tours 284-9607.
Served with balle de carotte à la McGregor.
Hey, Mad Dog, so you're trying out the Nouvelle Cuisine?
Sure, what could possibly go better with my La Bête Légère?
How's that?
Well, La Bête Light has less alcohol than regular beers, but it doesn't taste like water. The original recipe gives me great taste, 100%.
So, Monsieur Vachon, how'd you find your meal?
Well, I lifted up a carrot, and there it was. La Bête Light, 100% great taste.
Let's go back down, ladies and gentlemen, to the match we just saw, and this crowd is stunned.
The Dragon's shoulders were down. No controversy in my mind on that.
I don't think the Dragon's shoulders were down for the count of one. I think maybe two and three. We'll have to take another look at it, but right now, let's go up to ringside.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. In the ring from East Providence, Rhode Island, weighing 248 pounds, Silvano Sousa. And his opponent, to be led towards the ring by the Doctor of Style, Slick, from Chicago, Illinois, weighing 450 pounds, the One Man Gang.
450 pounds.
I'll tell you, I don't think I'd even want to be in the ring and have to look across at this guy.
A one-man gang, and he lives up to his reputation. He is just that. A one-man gang, 450 pounds. I can't believe it. Wait a minute, he's going to work with his opponent right away.
He don't waste no time, does he?
None whatsoever. The Slickster has found something here in the one-man gang. Gang just going to work. Snaps Sousa right off the top rope.
Maybe he's got a hot date.
I don't know about that.
Look at the Gang. He is huge.
He's huge, and he really knows how to use that 450-some-odd pounds of his. He can use that weight.
Off the rope now, the Gang.
Ooh, puts the boot to him.
We take you now, ladies and gentlemen, to Slick.
I know you wants to hear more about the Master Blaster, and I know you would. But guess what? Don't worry about hearing. Just keep them big eyes open, because after all, seeing is believing.
Yeah.
It is, huh?
Punish him.
I believe.
Yeah.
Because I see. You know, I just wonder, though, do you think Brutus the Barber does his hair? It looks like a beefcake haircut.
Uh-oh. What's this now? The Gang up on the second rope. 450 pounds of him. Boom! Wow. Rams the head of his opponent down to the canvas.
Ain't nobody gonna get up from that.
I don't think so either. Sousa's hardly moving. What's this now?
He's going back up again.
For what? The Gang walking the ropes. Boom! The back of the neck.
Wow.
You can tell that tonight. Tell this party's all over, baby.
The Slickster very happy with the victory of the one-man Gang.
Here's our winner, the one-man Gang.
One-man Gang victorious, and that's what polished off Silvano. Sousa, let's take you now to a special interview.
All right, Gene Okerlund here standing by. In New York City at Madison Square Garden, and in regards to the big card coming up at the Forum in Montreal Monday, June the 29th, I want to tell you, the Killer Bees are going to be challenging the Hart Foundation for the World Wrestling Federation.